There was some kind of party going down in paradise. When everybody got hungry, doesn't that food look nice? So they ate the apple, they ate it down to the core. Adam turned to Eve, he said, I want some more. Hardcore, I've seen everything and I've seen nothing, but you're something I never saw before. Hardcore, when I press my flesh beside you, show me what love is for. I bought love for money, I sold love for hate. I traded trust for suspicion, it was a big time mistake. Ah, give me your hand, take it in mine, and take a chance on the real thing one last time. Hardcore, I've seen everything and I've seen nothing, but you're something I never saw before. Your flesh beside me, show me what love is for. Now I like what you like, that's alright. Well, you were just what I was looking for. And when I touch you, can I trust you that it's just you who's gonna stop me what I'm looking for? Give me true highway affection. Please don't ask where I'm going, I'm trying to race the line. And drive all night. 'Cause I got what's left and I know what's right. I never liked where I came from, and I tried to fight. Oh, they need development, rearrangement, and dynamite. But you'll be my reflection. Let your memory die. And drive on. I got what's left and I know what's right. We hit the coast in a T-bird called Teenage. I'm heading out for a psychologically clean age. And if they stop you, they say, just where are you? Drive all night, give me true highway affection, and drive all night. And if the sun starts to catch us, gonna paint our windows black. Sunday night, when you just can't go home, 'cause nothing was right. So we sneak into your house, but it's the wrong one, 'cause they all look the same. This town's no fun. I finally got it right, and if your daddy knew, he'd kill. Because I got the keys to his brand new coupe de ville, and I'm hitting that highway 101.
Well, I think like most of my generation, it was, you know, the Beatles and the Stones and Dylan and Lou Reed, I guess the Velvet Underground too. And, you know, I started playing the guitar at 12. It was to keep me settled down in school, which didn't work. And then I came to Europe in 71. I was singing on the streets and in the metro in Paris. And that's really where I started to write songs. And... because for me, it all begins with a song, you know, the song and the guitar. And then I went back to in America and started making albums. This is my 25th year on the road. The great thing about growing up in America when I did is there was really this explosion in musical culture with the blues and jazz and country and rock and roll, and much less than there is today. Today it's become all a little too corporate and homogenized for my taste.
So I could paint a portrait of you, and the world would see you as I do, with your pretty smile, brown, brown eyes, just like Mona Lisa in the Louvre. I would cover every part of you when you dive into me. With your so soft skin, black, black hair, I'm the wave that's gonna take you to my sea. Mississippi, watching that river flow down to the Gulf of Mexico. Well, that's how strong I long for. That's how strong I long for. That's how strong I long for you to be.
This next song is called On Elvis Presley's Birthday. It's not really a song about Elvis, it's a song about a day I passed with my father a long time ago. But just in case we have some Elvis fans out there tonight, we'll give you a little bit of this. Love me tender. Love me true, never let me go. For you know that I love you and I need you so. Love me tender, love me long, all my dreams fulfilled. For you know that. Particular geographic location, but I've grown used to it, and now I miss it when I'm away. Of course, when I was a child, my father would take me with him down to the Bowery, and in the restaurant supply stores, he would buy shiny steel refrigerators and deadly looking stoves while I begged him to take me down to Canal Street and buy me some big dead bullets. He wore a short corduroy jacket and a feather in his hat, and he talked with his hands in his pants pockets, jangling change. Cadillac
on Elvis Presley's birthday. They said it on the radio. My father liked Elvis, and it was wonderful. It was wonderful. We drove through the black neighborhoods of Long Island, North Shore, when Elvis was alive. You see, my father was from Brooklyn, and the Depression left its mark. From picking up coal on the railroad tracks, and still, he didn't have a good word to say about Franklin Delano Roosevelt. Nope. Now later, I liked elegant hotel bars where I could drink under F. Scott Fitzgerald skies, the coolest of the cool. I was never a child. With my dead father jangling change on Elvis Presley's birthday. This is an unreal city. You can be anybody. Be when you're alone. Hey, hey.
Speaking to a friend of mine, Garland Jeffries, who you may know, a singer, and I told him, in fact, I was getting divorced, and I just didn't have the heart to get another apartment in New York City, and he said, what do you want to do? And I said, well, I'd really like to move to Paris, and he said, well, I got a friend who's got a place there, maybe he'll rent it to you, and 2 weeks later, I was there. So it was really thanks to Garland that I moved here, and, you know, I guess I'm an expatriate. We're the kind of people who feel more at home when we're not at home. That's kind of a tradition of a lot of American artists and musicians who have lived in Paris, especially. In my experience, the audiences in Europe have been a little less fickle, a little more faithful to the artists they like and support, and less manipulated by the media, though I think that's changing a little bit now. But what I really like about it, now I play with Olivier Durand, my guitarist, and it's just two of us, and it's an acoustic duo, and we really have a very intimate relationship with the audience, and I really love that. I really need to get the energy back from the audience. Sometimes with a band, you just kind of overpower the audience, you know. It doesn't really matter if they're there or not, but with our shows, the audience become part of the band.
You're so young to have seen it, and now your vision is much too old and much too clear. You see, I'm friends with that darkness you've been seeing. We dated once or twice in earlier years. And I know you're trying. And believe me, I know things get tough. But I've seen you when you're dancing with the children. Skip ahead to the lighter stuff. I can't see you no more, 'cause they'll draw out your life through a fine silver straw. And if I was a hero, I would have fought them all at your door. At your door. thinking of your family, and maybe you're thinking that it's been just a little too long, because you need some of their innocence, some of their order. But I say that medicine, it can taste so strong, and we're holding so tight, we're falling, and the funny thing is that both are nearly the same. You know, freedom, it finds its own amusement. I think we found a waiting game, a way you torture yourself for the moment, when the only thing left is to feel. They say romantics run free in the darkness, yeah, but come the light, and they're the first to kneel. Say they can't see you no more, 'cause they'll draw out your life through a blind silver straw. And if I was a hero, I would have fought them all at your door. But the lines we have drawn and the signs we have chose, and my own indecision, well, how badly that shows. And goddamn, if I was a hero, I would have kept a little world. on the guitar tonight. From La Havre, France, Olivier Lightning Durant.
Politically, I guess I belong to the party of cynicism, you know. I'm pretty cynical when it comes to politics on both sides. I guess especially growing up during the Vietnam War era, which was supported by both the left and the right in America. So, you know, I guess if I believe in anything, it's kind of individual responsibility, taking responsibility for your own life. And in my own, you know... And I guess I believe in freedom and independence, because if I hadn't been allowed to travel all over the world like I have, you know, I never would have gotten anywhere.
From the peninsula, we stare across the bay. From the peninsula, we talk of yesterday. We talk of parties that were over, who the midnight boys took home. I sit and watch streetwalkers talking on handy phones. Out for a moonlight swim, she glides across the bay. We took a motor car, we're gonna meet you halfway. And we waited for an hour, we searched the whole next day. They never ever found nobody, you know, some parties just end up that way. That way. Its words are gonna stay. Like a teenage nymph who gave everything away. They used to find him in the morning, his head held in his hands. He was crying about Lolita. He said, nobody's gonna understand. Understand. He started talking. Said they never ever lose their way. He said, well, us white men, you know the magic, it can just fade away. Some say the opium drove him crazy, some say the Beaujolais drove him insane. But there's an Indian girl, she's called Lolita, she dances down in Mexico in the rain, in the steaming rain. You thought you wouldn't do. You thought you
Now I'd like to introduce the band to you. On the drums, we got John Bonham on the drums back here. On the bass guitar, Sid Vicious on the bass guitar. On the rhythm guitar, Johnny Thunders on the rhythm guitar. And on the lead guitar, Jimi Hendrix on the lead guitar. Quickly, that you may not know this, but Gloria was written in a medieval monastery about 1,000 years ago. You see, there was a group of monks, and they were not allowed to say a word except at Christmas dinner. So Christmas dinner came around, and the youngest monk, he stood up and he said, wait for a whole year to go by, you know, 365 days. And next Christmas dinner, the monk next to him, he stood up and he said, L. So things were getting pretty exciting now. So a whole year went by. In fact, 366 days, it was a leap year. And the oldest monk, who'd been there for like 100 years, he stood up. And he dropped dead, and they had to wait a whole nother year, you know. But finally came the day. Brother Jim Morrison stood up, and he stood up on the chair, and he stood up on the table, and he looked him all in the eye, and he said, ay, 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 G-L-O-R. Thank you very much for coming. Yeah.
Well, you know, last night I was on stage and in Tübingen, a little town.
Yeah.
And I looked out at that audience and I said to them, you know, it's not because of MTV that I'm here tonight. And it's not because of any major record corporation. It's really because of people like you who've come to all these shows over all these years and bought my albums. And it's really the public that keeps me going, you know? And I'm really grateful to them for that. As I said, this is my 25th year, and I figure I can go another 25.
When the moon was just right, we could turn out the lights and just listen. We could pray to the night, hold on so tight. You could hear crystal stars as they glisten. A lover is in vain, like to walk in the rain, like to hear a distant train's emotion. In a late radio, played very low, no one must know this devotion. Rock ballad. Rock ballad. And baby and I used to listen all night long to a real slow song. Until my tears, they were gone. Now these jobs and these schools, they say romance is for fools, and the dream always ends upon waking. So you learn to keep your cool, like how a hustler shoots pool. Soon your whole life is spent faking, because to try is to fail. And as the wind left your sails, all you hear are the sounds of their laughter. But I was running fast with the wind racing past. All I heard was a voice say, go after her. My baby and I used to listen all night long to a real slow song until my tears were gone. Just today we were riding the car here to do this show tonight. And we'd done about 6,000 kilometers together in the last couple of weeks. And I was looking at Olivier, and I was saying to myself, you know, he may not be from Texas or from Mississippi or New Orleans or Chicago, but I think you gotta admit that for a French boy, he plays the blues pretty well. Olivier Durand.